Dear students, as I told you in the last class, if there is autocorrelation or heteroscedasticity, OLS estimators are no longer blue. Now, what is blue is another estimator known as generalized least squares. Generalized least squares. Estimate, GLS estimate, also known as Aitken's estimate, also known as Aitken's estimate, Aitken's estimate. What is blue is GLS in the presence of autocorrelation or a heteroscedasticity or both. To introduce GLS, our model is y is equal to x beta plus u. Expected u transpose is equal to sigma square psi, and expected u is a null vector 0. And we assume that u is characterized by heteroscedasticity and first order autocorrelation. Psi, as I told you, is square, symmetric, and positive definite. Then, the most general form of heteroscedasticity is, if there is only heteroscedasticity, no autocorrelation, especially in cross-section data, sigma square 1, sigma square 2, sigma square n. If there is homoscedasticity, sigma square. But here the error variances are different. That is, variance of ui is not equal to sigma square, it is sigma square I. Sigma square 1, sigma square 2, etc., sigma square n. It vary from one observation point to another observation point. Then, the most general form of first order serial correlation is sigma square into 1, then rho square rho n minus 1, then rho n minus 1, then rho n minus 2, etc., up to 1. This is the most general form of first order serial correlation. I will explain this matrix in detail when we consider first order serial correlation and how we obtain these elements later. For the time being, just assume that this is the representation of first order serial correlation and this is the representation of heteroscedasticity. Now the question is, if expected u transpose is sigma square I psi rather than sigma square I, OLS estimators are not the best linear unbiased estimators. Even though OLS estimators are unbiased, they are no longer the minimum variance estimators. So, you will not obtain estimators which are blue. Now, the question is how to best estimate the model given that the disturbance is characterized by autocorrelation and first order serial, and I mean first order I mean heteroscedasticity and first order serial correlation. Application of OLS is misleading. If you ignore this problem, you will use the conventional variances. It is totally misleading. The entire procedure is invalid for hypothesis testing, for the construction of confidence intervals and the like. So the solution is we transform the original model in such a way that in the transformed model you satisfy all the classical assumptions. We cannot apply OLS to this model because you will not satisfy the classical assumptions. Two classical assumptions are violated. Now suppose that you can transform the model so that in the transformed model the U satisfy all the classical assumptions. Now the question is it possible to make such a transformation? The answer is we can transform the model if psi is positive definite. Psi is positive definite. There is a basic theorem in matrix algebra which states that if psi is positive definite, there exists a non-singular matrix P such that P psi P transpose is equal to I. This is a theorem which you by heart. If psi is positive definite, then there exists a non-singular matrix P such that P psi P transpose is equal to Y. This is a theorem and you study this theorem. This is possible if and only if psi is positive definite. P is non-singular. So this is equal to I if psi is equal to P inverse P transpose inverse. Psi is equal to P inverse P transpose inverse is equal to P transpose P inverse. P transpose P inverse is P inverse P transpose inverse. And psi inverse is equal to inverse of P transpose P inverse, that is P transpose P. P transpose P. So the point is we transform the original model in such a way that in the transformed model you satisfy all the classical assumptions. And if we apply OLS to the transformed model, the resulting estimators are known as generalized least squares estimators. So GLS is nothing but OLS applied to the transformed model. The model is transformed in such a way that the disturbance satisfies all the classical assumptions. So to that, we pre-multiply the model with P. Py is equal to Px beta plus P. Pre-multiply the entire model with the P. Now, let us see what is expected UU transpose in the transformed model is equal to expected value of PU transpose is equal to expected value of PU U transpose P transpose is equal to P into expected UU transpose P transpose. Expected UU transpose P transpose is equal to P into what is expected UU transpose? Sigma square psi P transpose. Sigma square is taken out, P psi P transpose, and is equal to sigma square I. Sigma square I. So the point is transforming the model means we pre-multiply with the P. And remember this, I will explain what is the P matrix in specific cases later. For the time being, you need not worry about this. Pre-multiply with the P, and expected UU transpose in the new model is expected PU PU transpose. Applying, you will get sigma square I. So in the transformed model,
you satisfy all the classical assumptions. So if you apply OLS to this model, the resulting estimators are blue. The resulting estimators are blue because here all the classical assumptions are satisfied. Now, if you apply OLS to this model, you will get the estimator beta star as equal to, the usual case is beta at x transpose x inverse x transpose y. Now here x is px, so px transpose px, px transpose px inverse px transpose py, px transpose px inverse px transpose py is equal to p into, then this is equal to x transpose p transpose px inverse x transpose p transpose py. Now what is p transpose p? That is psi. So is equal to x transpose psi x, p transpose is what is p transpose? As we have derived earlier, psi is equal to p transpose p inverse, and x trans and p transpose p is, p transpose p is psi inverse. P transpose p is psi inverse. So x transpose psi inverse x inverse x transpose psi inverse y. That is beta star. X transpose, remember this, P transpose P is psi inverse, just derived earlier. So this estimator beta star is known as Aitken's estimator or GLS estimator. As this estimator is obtained by applying OLS to a model satisfying all the classical assumptions, this beta star is blue. Beta star is blue. OLS is not blue. OLS is x transpose x inverse x transpose y. Not blue. This is blue because it satisfies all the classical assumptions. Now, let us see what is the variance, covariance of GLS, beta star. Compare this beta hat OLS, beta star GLS. Now, let us consider the variance, covariance, beta star. Before that, we can write beta star as equal to x transpose psi inverse x inverse x transpose psi inverse, that y is equal to x beta plus u. That will give you x transpose psi inverse x transpose psi inverse x beta plus x transpose psi inverse x transpose psi inverse u. That will give you x transpose psi inverse, x transpose psi inverse, x is psi. So beta star is equal to beta plus x transpose psi inverse, x transpose psi inverse u. If you take expectations, you will get expected u is equal to 0. So beta star is equal to beta. So GLS is unbiased. GLS is unbiased because GLS satisfies all the classical assumptions. Now let us see what is the variance, covariance of beta star. The variance, covariance of beta star is expected value of beta star minus beta, beta star minus beta transpose, the usual formula, C equal to, that is the variance covariance, is equal to beta star minus beta is C equal to expected value of x transpose psi inverse x inverse x transpose psi inverse u, then x transpose psi inverse x inverse x transpose psi inverse u transpose C equal to expected value of C equal to expected value of x transpose psi inverse x transpose psi inverse u u transpose x transpose u transpose extra u transpose x transpose x transpose psi inverse u, then u transpose psi inverse x transpose psi inverse x inverse psi inverse etc of symmetric transpose is psi matrix. So equal to, if you take a expectation inside, this becomes sigma square psi. So x transpose psi inverse, x transpose psi inverse. Now this is sigma square is taken out. It's taken out. Then psi and psi inverse become I. Then x transpose psi inverse, x transpose psi inverse, x again become I. That means sigma square into x transpose psi inverse, x inverse. That is the variance covariance matrix of beta star, the GLS. The GLS. And as GLS satisfy all the classical assumptions, as GLS satisfy all the classical assumptions, the variance is the minimum variance. The variance is the minimum variance. Here, remember the steps, psi, psi inverse I, then sigma square is taken out, x transpose psi inverse, x transpose psi inverse x again I, then what remains is x transpose psi inverse x inverse. Now, let me combine. And keep these formulas in mind. Beta hat is x transpose x inverse, x transpose y, and variance covariance beta hat is sigma square into x transpose x inverse. Beta star is equal to x transpose psi inverse x inverse x transpose psi inverse y, and variance covariance beta star is equal to sigma square into x transpose psi inverse x inverse. And as you can see, this variance covariance is derived from a model satisfying all the classical assumptions. So it is blue. And as variance covariance of beta hat is not equal to this, we can say that, beta hat is this, and the variance covariance of beta hat is in the case of autocorrelation and first order serial in the case of heteroscedasticity and autocorrelation was sigma square into x transpose x inverse x transpose psi x transpose x inverse. Compare these two. This is totally misleading. If in the model there is autocorrelation and heteroscedasticity, this is the formula. that you will get. This is the formula derived on the assumption that there is no autocorrelation or heteroscedasticity. So you compare this with this. And you know that this variance covariance is derived from a model satisfying all the classical assumptions. So naturally, this is blue. And as this is not the same as this, this is not blue. So variance of beta star is less than variance of beta hat. OLS is no longer blue. And this is known as generalized Gauss-Markov least squares theorem, or Aitken's generalization of Gauss-Markov theorem, which states that the generalized least squares is blue, not the OLS. In the model, y is equal to x beta plus u with the expected u u transpose is equal to sigma square psi rather than sigma square I. And in this formula, and also in all the variance formulas, there is an unknown. And we know that in this formula, sigma square is equal to sigma u hat I square by n minus k is equal to u hat transpose u hat by n minus k. U hat transpose u hat. But here, sigma hat square is u, now here is pu. So pu transpose pu by n minus k. This is equal to u transpose, sorry, pu hat transpose u hat, because all our estimates are based on hat. So u hat transpose, u hat transpose p transpose p u hat by n minus k. And this is equal to u hat transpose p transpose p is psi inverse u hat by n minus k. So this formula is used to calculate sigma hat square in this GLS, sigma hat square in the case of GLS. And remember this theorem, the theorem generalized Gauss-Markov least squares theorem, also known as Aitken's generalization of Gauss-Markov theorem. It states that the generalized least squares, in the generalized least squares is blue rather than OLS in the generalized least squares regression model. And in matrix form, this formula satisfies all the classical assumptions. So this is blue, this is not. A proof is not required here because we know that this is true always. Now there is one more point here. The point is beta star is x transpose psi inverse x inverse x transpose psi inverse y. Now the psi matrix in most cases is unknown. So we cannot apply GLS. Psi matrix in most cases is unknown. So we cannot apply OLS. So what we do is, in practice, we estimate the components of psi matrix. We estimate the elements of psi matrix. Then substitute these values in the GLS formula. That is, beta star is equal to x transpose psi hat inverse x transpose psi hat inverse y. What we do is we estimate the elements of psi hat that we will explain later using non-matrix algebra. So estimate the elements of psi hat and substitute these estimated values in the GLS formula. Then we have what is known as feasible GLS. And this procedure is also known as two-stage Aitken estimator. This procedure, two-stage Aitken estimator or feasible GLS Aitken estimator, is given by x transpose psi hat inverse x inverse, x transpose psi hat inverse, and one more point, GLS is blue, feasible GLS is not. Feasible GLS is biased, but they are consistent. Feasible GLS is not unbiased, or blue property is unknown. What is known is only the large sample property of consistency. We can prove that feasible GLS is consistent. And remember this, even if you have some doubt about the procedures I have discussed, you simply postpone it to the next sessions, where I will discuss in detail heteroscedasticity and autocorrelation in detail. Then you come back to this, then these points will be very easy for you.